Good afternoon. Aloha, and thank you for joining us for this news conference about the $78 million in opioid settlement funds coming to Hawaii. Governor Ige is joined today with Honolulu Mayor Rick Blangiardi in person, and Mayor Mike Victorino will be available by Zoom. Following the remarks, then we'll take media questions and answers. Media are here in the room, as well as participating virtually. And with that, Governor Ige.
Thank you for joining us this afternoon. Our nation is facing a serious opioid crisis that is claiming the lives of thousands of people, plunging families into tragedy, and taking a devastating toll on society. While Hawaii often experiences public health trends well after they occur on the mainland, warning signs are appearing. Fatalities from drug poisoning have outpaced auto accidents in Hawaii this year. Nationwide, 140 Americans die every day from drug overdoses, with 91 caused by opioids, according to the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. In Hawaii, drug overdose deaths account for 24% of all fatal injuries, which include deaths from prescription opioids, and currently ranks Hawaii 37th in the nation in drug overdose deaths. These numbers represent real people. Too many of us know children, spouses, and colleagues who are suffering every day from the impacts of drug addiction and misuse. In 2017, the statewide multi-agency Hawaii Opioid Initiative Action Plan has directed a coordinated response to not only opioids, but also methamphetamines and other prevalent drugs. Now, efforts to curb opioid abuse in Hawaii have gotten a shot of much-needed funding. Recently, nationwide settlements totaling $26 billion have been reached to resolve lawsuits against the three largest drug distributors and one of the largest drug manufacturers, based on a formula that takes into account the population and impact of the opioid crisis in the state. Hawaii will receive approximately $78 million from these settlements. These include approximately $63 million over 18 years from the settlement with the three major distributors, and $15 million over 9 years from Johnson & Johnson. The state and each one of the counties have agreed to use 85% of the funds for opioid treatment, prevention, and education, as well as other abatement measures and strategies. The other 15% will be used for treatment, prevention, and education for other substances. The state and counties have signed a memorandum of agreement that will facilitate compliance with the national settlement agreements. Under this agreement, 85% of the opioid settlement funds will be spent in consultation with the advisory committee composed of equal numbers of state and county representatives. Each year, at least 15% of the total will be spent at the county level, and each county will determine how its respective share is spent. One of the first statewide activities will be embarking on a statewide needs assessment. This will help the advisory committee to shape future activities and direct funding to where it is needed most. Other anticipated settlements with major drug makers will contribute millions more to the state and county's abatement efforts. In addition, cases against and investigations into other opioid actors are ongoing, and Hawaii could see millions more when these are concluded. I want to thank all the mayors, the community, healthcare, and government stakeholders who have come together to help the people of Hawaii. Our efforts will be successful because all stakeholders are working closely together to achieve success in fighting this opioid crisis. Thank you.
Thank you, Governor. Our next speaker will be Mayor Rick Blangiardi.
Good afternoon. I'm here today in support of the governor, our state, and as mayor of the city and county of Honolulu to assure the residents of our island that we will do everything we can with the monies available to help with this fight. I don't think I could add anything to what the governor just said about the statistics that are impacting us. I know firsthand how real this is, how many people have been really hurt by this, how many families have been destroyed, and it's something that we have to really, we really have to educate people and help our communities. So with that, we're very grateful these monies will be available. As the governor said, once we get the needs assessment done on how best we can spend it, we will spend every dollar in our fight against this opioid crisis. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor. Mayor Mike Victorino, please go ahead.
I welcome the opportunity to work with Governor Igi and the State Department of Health and my fellow mayors to resolve this opioid crisis in all of our communities. We stand together, united, to fight opioid addiction and ensure that our families, children, spouses, neighbors, co-workers don't become victims of drug addiction and misuse. So we stand together, and I too, and the people of my county, welcome this settlement. And then we will expend every dollar to make sure that all of this is used in a proper way. And again, I want to thank everyone that's made it possible. Again, when we all unite, we can overcome even big corporations. Mahalo.
Thank you, Mayor Victorino. Reporters, we're going to now move into Q&A. When it's your turn, please state your name and your outlet, and then the person to whom you're addressing your question. For those who are in the room, just come here so I can make sure I see you if you have a question. But to begin, Rick Desog, go ahead, please, Rick.
The opioid proceeds are going to be used for treatment, part of it. Can you talk about the status of the treatment centers and capacity that we have for opioid addiction? I mean, are we lacking in that?
That was a question for Governor, yes, Rick?
For everybody.
Okay.
Governor.
Okay, great. Thanks. Gov's going to start.
You know, certainly we realize that our current capacity for drug treatment and working through the addictions need to be increased over time. We do believe that this settlement will help with that. We will be getting funds for the next 15 years. We'll be able to do better planning be able to support more programs that help with opioid addiction specifically. But we also recognize that there are other drugs that are a menace to our community. And we certainly wanted to ensure that we had some funds that would help with other addictions.
Thanks. Mayor Victorino, anything from Maui County?
Well, we concur with Governor Igi, and we look forward. We will make this money available through our treatment centers and expand programs to protect and help those who have this misfortune of opioid addiction. So we stand ready to use the money in these areas. And yes, we want to expand our services with additional funding.
Thank you, Mayor. Next question comes from Manolo Morales.
This is also for the governor, and if the mayors also want to add on. You mentioned other drugs, and I think there's a growing concern with fentanyl about being brought here illegally. And just can you talk about how this can address some of that and with this money?
Yeah, certainly one of the tenets of the settlement agreement was to focus the bulk of it on opioids specifically, but to allow for a certain percentage, 15%, to be used to address other drugs that are prevalent in the community, as you had mentioned, fentanyl. So, I mean, I think that that's the way that that settlement was structured. We do intend to. We're creating an advisory committee. As had stated, we will be doing a needs assessment to try and identify the capacity and the areas and gaps that currently exist in our community, so that we can make targeted investments in those areas of most need.
Thank you, Governor. Rick Desog, I see your, sorry, that was evidently a leftover. Andrew Gomes, please go ahead.
Thank you. This question is for the governor. About how long might you estimate the work will take before spending the money happens? You know, how far off is actual spending?
I don't have that information with me right now, but we certainly can get that answer back to you.
Okay. Thank you. And Andrew, did you have a follow-up?
Okay, sure. Can you clarify the split with the counties? Is it all the counties will share 15% and then 85% would be spent by the state?
You know, the funds will be directed by the advisory committee, which will be half state and half counties. You know, there probably would be statewide programs that would be rolled out to, you know, statewide supporters. In addition, there will be county specific funds available for county specific programs. So we did want to make sure that we attack this crisis as an all of community effort. We felt that it was very important that that the counties have resources to implement programs that are specific to their counties. In addition, we will have an overall statewide program.
Thank you. And now I do see Rick Desog's hand. Rick, go ahead, please.
A lot of money, but I think you used the number of the total settlement numbers for all the states was $2.66 billion. That comes to about 3%. Is that, and Hawaii's problem seems to be pretty severe. Is this just the first tranche of money that Hawaii will see, or is this all?
This is the first few settlements from the three largest distributors and one large manufacturer. We do, and we have other pending cases against other distributors and other manufacturers. So we do anticipate that there will be more funds that will be made available. You know, Rick, Hawaii ranks 35th in per capita opioid-related deaths. So, you know, we have been proactive here in the state because of our universal health care. We did have more information at the very early stages of the crisis. We did respond pretty rapidly to change the starting doses and for prescriptions, and implemented a lot of the recommendations that minimize opioid abuse and overdoses. We still know that the drugs got into our community and that families and people were affected. And so, you know, Rick, we felt that trying to litigate this issue by ourselves would be very expensive. And so we did choose to join consortiums where we felt that Hawaii would get an appropriate share.
Okay. Reporters, any other questions? Andrew, go ahead.
Okay, thanks. I recall an announcement in February. I believe it was related to this settlement, and the figure then was $73 million. So did Hawaii basically, you know, get a boost of $5 million? And What was that due to?
We can certainly follow up with you and get you that details. I don't have the specific calculations that was used at that announcement.
Cassie Ordonio?
This is for the governor or for the county mayors. I just kind of want to clarify, you know, since we're getting this tranche of money, can you kind of specify how that money is going to be, or where is the money going to be going to certain organizations or services, and can you name them?
I can't name them specifically, but obviously there are nonprofits in our community that focus on drug addiction and treatment. So I would imagine that they would get the lion's share of the education and prevention funds. You know, in addition to that, we are doing a needs assessment. That's one of the first things that we all agreed is necessary. And that really would give us the opportunity to determine how and where the opioid crisis is most prevalent, and what are the services that are needed, and the service providers to allow us to comprehensively look at the situation here, in specifically in the state of Hawaii.
And Mayor Victorino or Blangiardi, did you want to add to that?
Well, I'll start if you don't mind. I'll go ahead and start. So quickly, that we have, just as the governor mentioned, a number of nonprofits that really have been assisting Maui County for many, many years, which are to them and the healthcare system that we have available to us. And between those two and the State Department of Health, I think we could adequately provide the services, and with the additional money, maybe even expand services that are so badly needed.
Thank you, Mayor.
You know, we've been battling drug addiction in our community. And I can tell you clearly, over the last 20 years, when I came back to Hawaii, we were dealing with crystal meth as a major issue. And then over the years, crystal meth, which still remained in an epidemic situation, actually evolved into opioid addiction. And we know now, as somebody mentioned earlier, fentanyl. And these drugs kill. They destroy lives. So having money and resources available now to apply to an existing infrastructure of people who've been in place battling these conditions is only going to be something to the better. And so how it gets deployed, we'll find out. But there's no denying, the governor said in the statistics, that drug poisonings have surpassed automobile accidents. I mean, if that's not provocative in and of itself, I don't know what more you could say as far as how pervasive it is. So money's help in this equation, and no doubt we'll try to put it to the highest and best use against a very insidious enemy of our people.
Thank you, Mayor.
Okay.
Manolo?
While you're up there, Mayor.
Yes.
And this is for Mayor Victorino also, if you can. If you can, where would you like to set your priorities for something like this, as far as maybe a good chunk of the money to go?
Well, you know, I would say that for me, if I could just answer, I think, you know, a lot of it starts with education. And obviously starts with also trying to reach our young people. But this is something that spans all generations. So I think, you know, education, and then actually having treatment centers. You know, it's something that I've really gotten in touch with in our battle against homelessness and some of the other issues that we're dealing with, which we see mental illness, we see drug addiction, we see alcohol-related situations, and we know we need treatment centers. So I would say education and actual treatment centers are what we could do, and that involves staffing, too, to have professionals that can really know how to take care of these people, and then making whatever medicines we can make available to them to do that. So I look at it from a systemic standpoint that way, Manolo.
And Mayor Victorino? Anything to add?
Well, I would concur with Mayor Blangiardi. Again, the treatment centers would be pivotal. Education is really necessary. Most importantly, the community banding together, recognizing the problem, having the resources, and working as a community to help us through this opioid epidemic. This is not something new, and you're right. When I first got on the council some 15 years ago, this was a big thing in starting to resonate to the top. But the pharmacy companies were covering up, and just like the tobacco company, the day of reckoning has come, and now we will take care of it with their money that they have devastated some of our communities. So we're looking forward to working together with all the agencies that I mentioned before, Department of Health and others, who slow step forward.
Thank you, Mayor. Cassie Ordonia has another question, and then Rick, we will get to you next.
These are for the county mayors. I was wondering, because you guys are also getting some tranche of money, will that also be decided among the city councils? Will you also be conversating with them on how that money should be spent?
Mayor Victorino, you want to begin on that one?
I didn't get the question. I'm sorry, I couldn't hear her.
Sure, let me repeat that. The question is, for the county spending, will you be talking with the councils for that?
Absolutely. We will consult with the councils and utilize their wisdom and their ability to help us in this area. So yes, I would work with the councils and our council especially. And I think all of us have to take a proactive. It's a community effort, not just the mayors or the governor. The monies must be spent and must be spent in a wise and efficient manner.
Yes, and I don't know if the protocol requires that we work with the council, but I absolutely would want to work with the council to try to determine each respective district where the needs are. It's also part of that overview of doing an assessment on needs. So very much anticipate doing that.
Thank you. Rick Desaug, go ahead, please.
Hi, this is a question for Governor. As part of the strategy to battle opioid addiction, the state applies for what's known as a state opioid response plan. We're hearing that the state might have missed the critical deadline for one of these grants. Can you talk about that?
I couldn't hear the question.
Governor, the question was that Rick has a source that says the state may have missed a deadline for a grant application. I'm not sure that we would have information about that, Rick. My recommendation is you check in with Department of Health. Okay. Other questions? Any other questions on this topic? All right. Seeing no hands up, Manolo, you had an off topic.
Yeah. Governor, if you can, the Healthcare Association of Hawaii had talked about being able to waive licensing requirements so we can get healthcare workers from the mainland here. Have you thought about that, and is that something you would do as far as doing an emergency proclamation?
We are working with the Healthcare Association, the Department of Commerce and Consumer Affairs, the professional licensing. Agencies have been in dialogue with the hospitals and the association to determine what the needs are and what actions we can take to facilitate the traveling nurses and healthcare professionals.
So it could mean something different from the waiving of the requirements, or what?
Yeah, certainly. We're working to understand what the needs are. Determining how we can bring additional resources, healthcare resources here in a safe way to make sure that all the professionals who come to work here are fully licensed and capable. So we are getting close, I think, to finalizing that action. So we'll be making an announcement.
Cassie?
This is for the governor. For the new Mauna Kea Authority Board, what's the update on that since the deadline for the application was yesterday? Has anyone applied yet?
We did get a good number of applicants. I know the last time I talked with staff, we were above 30 or 35. So I think it was a good public response. We'll be going through reviewing the applications and then making decisions for appointments to that authority.
And when would that decision be made?
We don't have a specific timeline right now. I think the applications closed just yesterday. There were very specific categories of experiences that would be required to be represented on the board. So we're just reviewing the applications, trying to sort through the different roles that people had applied for, and then we'll be going through and vetting the applicants.
Okay. Anything else? Okay, Governor, any closing comments?
No, just really wanted to thank the mayors and thank everyone in the community involved. This opioid crisis has affected many families in our community, and we are thankful that we are able to have these settlements, which will allow us to move forward, as the mayor said, with a focus on prevention and treatment, which we believe is most needed in our community. And we anticipate that the assessment will help us identify any gaps and focus the funds in the appropriate places. So thank you all.
Thank you, Governor. Thank you, Mayors.
Aloha.